हमने हम अपने कुछ लास्ट सेशंस में लेक्चर्स में ये स्टडी करते रहे हैं कि लाइक किस तरह से इलेक्ट्रिकल करेक्टरिस्टिक्स जो हैं वो वेरी करती हैं फॉर और लाइक गेट्स या मॉसफेट्स, जिसमें हमने कुछ इलेक्ट्रिकल करेक्टरिस्टिक्स पढ़ी थी, जिसमें हमने रेजिस्टेंसेज कैपेसिटेंसेज के बारे में पढ़ा था। सिमिलरली वी हैव लाइक वी हैड अनदर सेशन वेयर वी स्टडीड अबाउट लाइक दी इंटरकनेक्ट रेजिस्टेंस एज वेल। सो अभी हमने जो स्टडी करना है वो बेसिकली ये है कि हम किस तरह से लाइक डीसी एनालिसिस कर सकते हैं फॉर और गेट्स, टिपिकली लाइक स्पेसिफिकली वी विल सी एन एग्जांपल ऑफ एन इन्वर्टर। सो व्हाट वी नीड टू स्टडी इज के हम ये देखना चाहते हैं कि हाउ कैन वी डिज़ाइन एन इन्वर्टर दैट लाइक जस्टिफाइज और रिक्वायरमेंट्स, और हाउ कैन वी डिज़ाइन एन इन्वर्टर लाइक अकॉर्डिंग टू आवर रिक्वायरमेंट्स। सो फॉर दैट फर्स्ट थिंग टू लाइक अंडरस्टैंड इज वी हैव डिफरेंट टाइप ऑफ एनालिसिस। फर्स्ट एनालिसिस इज आवर डीसी एनालिसिस। इस एनालिसिस में बेसिकली ये होता है कि हमारी जो इनपुट है, वी अज्यूम कि हमारी इनपुट जो है वो स्लोली चेंज हो रही है, एंड लाइक वी डोंट मेजर आउटपुट लाइक इमीडिएटली और लाइक ऑन वेरी फ्रीक्वेंट बेसिस। सो वी ओनली मेजर आवर आउटपुट व्हेन इट हैज बीन स्टेबलाइज्ड। So there is a direct mapping of input to the output, like we say that like there is a direct mapping hamari input aur output ke beech mein, like whenever our input changes, output like changes as well on depending on our input, and also like defined voltage ranges are used, which are like logic level 0 and logic level 1. Like we are not like considering other type of levels like time dependency or other things. The second type of analysis is known as the transient analysis. इस analysis में हम लोग input voltage को like consider करते हैं कि that is a function of like time. हम जो analysis करेंगे उसमें हमने ये study करना है कि हमारी input voltage with respect to time कैसे change होती है, and correspondingly how our output changes accordingly, like how our output changes like with respect to time. And we have studied earlier like the delay between input and corresponding output is like a fundamental limiting factor for high speed designs. हमने एक अपने वीडियो लेक्चर में लाइक हमारे वीडियो सेशन में हमने ये डिस्कस किया था कि हमारे जो गेट्स हैं वो किस तरह से लाइक उसकी फ्रिक्वेंसी को लिमिट किया जा सकता है या वो कैसे लिमिटेड हो सकती है। तो दैट बेसिकली डिपेंड्स ऑन द डिले बिटवीन इनपुट एंड आउटपुट। सो लाइक व्हेनेवर व्हाट वी सेड दैट एट दैट टाइम इज लाइक व्हेनेवर आवर इनपुट चेंजेस कोरिस्पोंडिंगली आवर आउटपुट शुड बी लाइक अपडेटेड, नॉट ऑब्वियसली नॉट वेरी डिले। सो दैट और हम ये कह रहे हैं कि ये जो हमारा बेसिकली जो इनपुट और आउटपुट के बीच में ये जो डिले है, ये हमारा एक लिमिटिंग फैक्टर है फॉर हाई स्पीड डिजाइंस। तो अगर डिले हमारा ज़्यादा होगा तो हमारा जो सर्किट है वो हाई स्पीड सर्किट हम डिज़ाइन नहीं कर सकते। अगर हमारा डिले शॉर्ट होगा, जितना हम शॉर्ट डिले रख सकते हैं ऑब्वियसली दैट इज़ रिक्वायर्ड, हमारा उतना ही हाई स्पीड डिज़ाइन जो है वो आप अचीव कर सकते हैं। सो फॉर लाइक डीसी एनालिसिस वी विल स्टार्ट फ्रॉम एन इन्वर्टर सर्किट, लाइक वी से दैट इट प्रोवाइड्स बेसिस फॉर लाइक आवर एनालिसिस। सो एन इन्वर्टर इज मेड अप ऑफ लाइक टू गेट्स, लाइक वी हैव वन पीमोस हेयर एंड देन वी हैव वन एनमोस हेयर। देर आर टू टाइप ऑफ गेट्स यूज इन इन्वर्टर। सिमिलरली द अप्लाइड वोल्टेज वी इन, लाइक दिस वी इन डिटरमिन्स द स्टेट ऑफ टू मॉसफेट्स, लाइक डिपेंडिंग ऑन दिस इनपुट वोल्टेज इधर पीमोस और एनमोस विल बी ऑन और ऑफ विल बी ऑन और ऑफ स्टेट। सिमिलरली दिस बोथ लाइक मॉसफेट्स, वन इज द पीमोस एंड एनमोस, बोथ हैव लाइक डिफरेंट कैरेक्टरिस्टिक्स। We know that PMOS has like PMOS has this threshold voltage which is VTP is less than 0 volts, and our NMOS has this threshold voltage which is VTN which is greater than 0 volts. Like this is the threshold of PMOS is negative quantity and threshold of NMOS is like positive quantity. एंड सिमिलरली हमारे पास बीटा बीटा की वैल्यूज डिफरेंट हैं फॉर लाइक बोथ लाइक पीमोस एंड एनमोस बिकॉज लाइक बीटा पी डिपेंड्स ऑन के पी एंड बीटा एन डिपेंड्स ऑन के एन एंड सिमिलरली दिस ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन डब्ल्यू एंड एल ऑफ पीमोस एंड दिस ऑल्सो डिपेंड्स ऑन डब्ल्यू एंड एल ऑफ एनमोस. हम इस लेक्चर के लेटेस्ट पार्ट में लाइक लेटर पार्ट में हम ये देखेंगे कि ये डब्ल्यू एल और पी लाइक डब्ल्यू बाई एल पी और डब्ल्यू बाई एल एन में क्या डिफरेंस है, व्हाई वी कॉल इट डब्ल्यू लाइक डब्ल्यू बाई एल पी एंड डब्ल्यू बाई एल एन. सो व्हाट वी नीड टू ऑब्जर्व इज लाइक वी हैव टू ऑब्जर्व डिफरेंट वोल्टेजेस लाइक व्हाट टाइप ऑफ वोल्टेजेस वी हैव एंड व्हाट रेंज वी हैव फॉर द लाइक लो एंड हाई वोल्टेजेस. For that, first we have to study the endpoint voltages, like we consider this case, when input is low, like हमारे पास यहाँ पे जब ये input low होगी, like this voltage from like this terminal to this ground terminal, this voltage is zero, so it means our like this NMOS is turned off and our PMOS is turned on. So like it means like this PMOS is conducting like this is conducting current here. So we can say that the output is given as like VOH which is equal to VDD. Like consider the symbol here, like हमें ये symbol आगे use करना है. So this means that output high voltage. It means के whenever our PMOS is conducting, there will be a high voltage at output. That is represented by VOH. Like this is the maximum output voltage that is achieved by the PMOS, or you can say like it is achieved by the inverter. Similarly, when input is high, like we change this input to VDD, our PMOS turns off and our like NMOS starts conducting. When this NMOS is conducting, we can say that VOL is equal to like zero. The output voltage is like zero because this terminal is connected to ground now. So there is another voltage level which defines our low output low voltage. So there are two different levels. One is output high voltage and the other one is output low voltage. And we can also represent here a total logic swing at output. Like how this voltage varies from like from lower like lowest level to highest level. So that level can be found by subtracting these two levels, high level and low level, which will in this case this will be equal to VDD. So total logic swing at output is VL, which is given by which is obviously equal to VDD, and this is also known as full rail output, like from 0 volt to VDD. Because like we are getting full logic swing of like VDD. अगर हमारे पास यहाँ कहीं पे अगर कुछ voltage less होती like for example I can say like VDD by 2, then we cannot say that this is a full rail output because we are not getting the voltage range from 0 to VDD. So to understand the voltage levels, we need to understand this voltage transfer characteristics. This is basically a plot that is between V out and V in. Like we are plotting on like this y axis V out, and then like on x axis we have our V in. So this is a plot which represents our input and output voltage relation. Like to understand these voltages, like we have different voltages here. We need to write like different voltages in form of V in and V out. For example, we have first voltage as VGSN. VGSN is voltage that is from this gate terminal to this ground terminal. So in this case, when we have an inverter here, we have input here V in, and we can say that VGSN is equal to V in. But in other case, we have VSGP. VSGP is a voltage that is from this gate terminal to this this drain terminal, this source terminal. So this voltage can be calculated by VDD minus this VIN. Like if we subtract this VDD, like if we subtract this VIN from this VDD, we will get this VGSP. VSGP. So this is our like two different voltages. we would consider two different cases, like when our like MN is in cutoff and when our like PMOS in cutoff. So first we consider ke hamare paas jo MN hai, like hamare paas NMOS hai, that is working in cutoff. Like as long as Vin is less than V threshold, obviously we know that ke hamara NMOS jo hai wo cutoff region mein rehta hai unless ke hamare paas jo Vin hai wo V threshold voltage se badh jaye. तो हम ये कह सकते हैं कि अगर कट ऑफ मोड में लाइक अगर ये कट ऑफ मोड में है तो कन्वर्सली हमारे पास क्या हो रहा होगा कि हमारे पास जो पी मॉस है बेसिकली वो हाई वोल्टेज से कनेक्ट होगा. सो आउटपुट वोल्टेज इज हाई, लाइक इफ दिस इज ऑफ दिस पी मॉस इज ऑन, सो दिस वीडीडी इज कनेक्टेड टू हेयर एट द आउटपुट लेवल एंड वोल्टेज इज इन रेंज जीरो. लाइक इफ वी सी एट दिस ग्राफ there is a range of voltage which defines as like low voltage level. Like अब यहाँ पे देखें कि ये 0 volt है और यहाँ पे हमारे पास एक different level है voltage का जो कि input voltage है, इसको represent किया गया है with like 0 range, 0 like logic level 0. So it means के हमारे पास low logic doesn't mean के we are talking about like 0 volts. हमारी जो voltage range है वो vary कर सकती है. यहाँ पे फॉर एग्जाम्पल यहाँ पे हम देख सकते हैं. सिमिलरली व्हेन आर वी इन इंक्रीजेस, लाइक वी अज्यूम्ड के हमारे पास वी इन जो था वो जीरो था. जब हमारे पास वी इन जीरो था तो हमारा ये गेट जो है बेसिकली ये जो एन मोस है ये हमारा ऑफ स्टेट में था, ये कट ऑफ स्टेट में था. बट नाउ आर वी इन स्टार्ट इंक्रीजिंग. जब ये इंक्रीज करेगा लाइक यू कैन सी इन दिस ग्राफ, लाइक जब ये इंक्रीज करना शुरू करेगा दिस वी इन, so what would happen like the downward transition in VTC, like when we increase this Vin after some point it would start decreasing, like the output would start decreasing and then it will go eventually to zero. But what happens is like MFET is turned on, like humne isko on kar diya jab humne ye voltage apply karne shuru ki, लाइक हमारी वोल्टेज 0.7 वोल्ट से बढ़ गई. फॉर एग्जांपल हमारे पास यहाँ पे 0.7 वोल्ट आ जाता है. लेकिन हमारे पास जब 0.7 वोल्ट है तो लाइक हम अभी हमारे पास जो पी फेट है वो पी कंडक्ट कर रहा है, वो ऑफ नहीं हुआ, हमारा कंप्लीटली ऑफ नहीं हुआ. सो वी वुड हैव अ ट्रांजिशन पीरियड हियर, लाइक वी विल नॉट हैव लाइक वन आउटपुट एंड देन अब्रप्टली अ जीरो आउटपुट. वी विल हैव अ ट्रांजिशन पीरियड. This transition period is because like NFET is turned on and like PFET is still conducting. However, के हमारे पास जो Vin है वो हमारी VSGP को भी decrease करती है because we found out this formula to be VDD minus Vin. Like whenever Vin increases, this voltage decreases. So PFET becomes less efficient. Like जैसे ही ये threshold level जो है ये आपका threshold level decrease करता रहेगा तो हमारे पास ये वाला जो MOSFET है ये लेस एफिशिएंट रहेगा, ये लेस एफिशिएंट होता जाएगा लाइक कॉन्टिन्यूसली. सो एट सम पॉइंट इट विल इवेंचुअली गो टू कट ऑफ रीजन. बट व्हाट इज द कंडीशन फॉर दिस कट ऑफ रीजन व्हिच इज लाइक VSGP शुड बी लेस देन और इक्वल टू VTP. सो MP goes in cutoff when like this condition satisfied, like Vin is equal to VDD minus VTP. So Vout goes to zero, like this output goes to zero at this level, and we can say that there is a range of voltages which are defined as logic high. Here you can see that we have a range where we are defining like this logic high level. सो वी कैन से दैट हमारे पास डिफरेंट वोल्टेज लेवल्स हैं जो कि डिफाइन करते हैं कि हमारी लो लेवल लाइक वोल्टेज क्या है और हमारी हाई लेवल वोल्टेज क्या है, रादर देन वी आर लाइक टॉकिंग अबाउट जीरो एंड हाई वोल्टेजेस. सो हियर यू कैन सी दैट द अदर थिंग, लाइक वी हैव डिफाइंड टू डिफरेंट पॉइंट्स, लाइक दिस पॉइंट रिप्रेजेंट्स आवर लाइक लॉजिक लेवल बाउंड्री. And this point defines like boundary of high logic, high logic. So what these points are, like this range of logic 0 and logic 1 is defined by Channing slope. Like this slope basically determines ke hamare paas ye point kahan pe occur karega ya ye point ya ye jo edge hai ye kahan pe aayegi. Similarly this slope determines ke ye wala point kahan pe occur hona hai ya kahan pe lie karega. So we can say that, for example, if we consider this point A here, like at this point slope of this line is minus 1. Whenever slope of this line is minus 1, it means like it defines input low voltage. Like this is represented by this level, like V input low voltage. And similarly, logic is defined by 0 se leke hamare paas VIL tak. तो हमारे पास जो टोटल लॉजिक है जिसे हम लॉजिक लेवल जीरो कहते हैं वो वेरी करती है फ्रॉम जीरो टू VIL. सिमिलरली एट पॉइंट बी, लाइक एट दिस पॉइंट, हमारे पास स्लोप अगेन इट बिकम्स नेगेटिव, लाइक नेगेटिव 1. सो इट मींस के हमारी इनपुट हाई लॉजिक जो है या इनपुट हाई वोल्टेज है दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय VIH एंड इज डिफाइंड बाय लाइक दिस रेंज ऑफ वोल्टेजेस. सो वी हैव VIH टू VDD. This is our like range of high logic. So there is a chance ke hamare paas jo voltages hain wo overlap na karein, ya wo like input voltage jo hai wo output voltage ki range se overlap na kare. So it means ke hamare paas different noise margins jo hain wo like present hota hai. For example, this represents our output characteristics and this represents our input characteristics. We can see that this is our range of like logical high output range. Similarly, this range represents logical low output range. But if we see on the input characteristics side, we see that logical high input range has like a wider range, and similarly like low range also has a wide range. So what happens ke agar hum like अगर हम सब्ट्रैक्ट करें लाइक वी ओ एच माइनस वी आई एल को, लाइक यू कैन सी इट हियर, वी हैव वी ओ एच एंड वी हैव वी आई एच. इफ वी सब्ट्रैक्ट दीज टू वैल्यूज वी विल गेट अ नॉइज मार्जिन विच इज नोन एज वोल्टेज नॉइज मार्जिन हाई. एंड सिमिलरली फॉर वोल्टेज नॉइज मार्जिन लो वी कैन सब्ट्रैक्ट दिस वी आई एल एंड वी ओ एल. सो वी कैन अचीव दीज नॉइज मार्जिन्स. What these represents? These noise margins basically tells us how stable the inputs are with respect to a coupled like electromagnetic signal interference. If there is an interference, the noise margins will differ. And हम उससे ये basically conclude कर सकते हैं कि हमारे पास जो output आ रही है या जो हमारे पास noise margins आ रहे हैं वो basically क्या है, वो vary कर रहे हैं. तो it means there is a interference on the input signal. So we can detect a fault signal or like error signal. And obviously jitni noise hamari kam hogi that is better for our design. So another parameter which we have to look is like this midpoint voltage. Like what this voltage is, we have this point here, we are defining this point as where we have our output is equal to V in. So what midpoint voltage is, like where VTC, like we can say that it is a point where this VTC voltage transfer characteristics curve intersects unity gain line. Like this is a line for unity gain. Unity gain means like our input is equal to output, so we have this ratio is equal to 1. So there is a linear line here. तो जहां पे ये इंटरसेक्शन होगा, जहां पे ये इसको क्रॉस करेगी, हमारे पास इस पॉइंट पे उसे हम कहते हैं कि वो हमारे पास मिड पॉइंट वोल्टेज है, लाइक दैट इज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय Vm. एंड वी कैन से दैट वी आउट इज इक्वल टू वी इन एंड बोथ आर इक्वल टू Vm. लाइक वी आर सेइंग दैट दीज टू आर इक्वल टू Vm. सो इट डज नॉट रिप्रेजेंट एनी लॉजिक. Like at this point we cannot say like this point represents logic high or this point represents logic low. तो हमारे पास यहां पे कोई ऐसा लॉजिक होती नहीं है. एंड वी कैन से दैट फॉर वी इन इज ग्रेटर देन वी एम, लाइक इफ वी आर टॉकिंग अबाउट दिस लेवल, लाइक आवर इनपुट इज ग्रेटर देन वी एम we are talking about like on logic high side, and but not obviously quite there. Like if we say that हम इस लेवल इस वोल्टेज की बात कर रहे हैं यहाँ किसी पॉइंट पे, या ऑब्वियसली अगर हम यहाँ किसी पॉइंट पे बात करें तो वी कैन से दैट कि ये लॉजिक हाई साइड पे वोल्टेज होगी, बट नॉट लाइक टू दिस मार्क लाइक दिस वोल्टेज दिस हाई वोल्टेज, एंड ऑब्वियसली दैट द सेम गोज फॉर लाइक लो वोल्टेज एज वेल. एंड व्हेन वी इन इज इक्वल टू लाइक वी आउट इज इक्वल टू वी एम, we can say that both the transistors have equal drain currents, like our input is equal to output. So we assume that both these both transistors PMOS and NMOS have same currents. And to calculate this midpoint voltage, like we have to find mode of operation for like both MOSFETs. लाइक इसको कैलकुलेट करने के लिए हमें लाइक अगर हमने मिड पॉइंट वोल्टेज कैलकुलेट करनी है तो हमें बेसिकली क्या करना पड़ेगा, सबसे पहले हमें ये ऑब्जर्व करना है कि हमारे पास जो पी मॉस है और जो हमारा पास एन मॉस है उन दोनों का मोड ऑफ ऑपरेशन क्या है. लाइक इधर वो सैचुरेशन मोड में ऑपरेट करेंगे या वो नॉन सैचुरेशन मोड में ऑपरेट करेंगे. हमें ये जानना क्यों जरूरी है कि वो सैचुरेशन मोड या नॉन सैचुरेशन मोड में ऑपरेट करेंगे, वो इसलिए जरूरी है के then we would define like what formula we have to use for IDN and IDP. अगर हमें mode of operation पता नहीं होगा तो then we can make a mistake and we may not have accurate result.
So we have studied के हमारे पास जो important factor होता है for symmetric designs that is midpoint voltage, and we have also studied के at midpoint voltage हमारी जो करंट्स होती हैं फॉर बोथ लाइक PMOS एंड NMOS बोथ आर इक्वल. सो वी कैन से दैट लाइक फॉर दिस सेशन वी हैव टू फाइंड दिस लाइक मिड पॉइंट वोल्टेज. सो आवर टास्क इज फाइंडिंग मिड पॉइंट वोल्टेज दैट वॉज रिप्रेजेंटेड बाय VN. सो at this point we say that Vin is equal to or Vout, and this is represented by Vm, and we also said that IDN is equal to IDP, like our currents for like our PMOS and NMOS both are equal. So what we need to do is we need to find mode of operation of like both inverters, both like MOSFETs. So हमें जो mode of operation है both inverters का both like MOSFETs का वो हमें find करना है. So first of all like we will consider our NMOS. So our like first example is considering or like NMOS. For our NMOS, what we have like what we know is like our V saturation is equal to VGSN minus VTN. So for our NMOS, we know that V saturation is equal to VGSN. And if I draw here like the inverter design, it was like this one here. These gates are connected together. We have here VDD, we have here ground, and obviously this one is our out and this one represents our input. And if I highlight like what voltages we have here, this was our input, so we have a positive voltage here, positive terminal, and this is negative terminal, and this is VGSN. So and obviously agar hum isko bhi represent kar rahe hain, this is equal to VDSN. So this one is our like VDSN, and this other one is our like दिस इज VDSN. सो हमारे पास जो वोल्टेजेस हैं उसको हम इस तरह से रिप्रेजेंट कर सकते हैं. हेयर लाइक इन दिस डायग्राम और VGSN is represented by like this is our Vin voltage like from this point to this point. So this is equal to V, like this is equal to Vin. And we know that Vin is equal to Vm. So we can just say that VGSN is equal to Vm. And we know that this saturation voltage here. So if we put this VGSN to this V saturation voltage, then the saturation voltage equation will be V saturation is equal to Vm minus Vtn. And obviously the drain source voltage, like this voltage here, this is equal to VDSN is equal to Vout, like here this voltage, like from this terminal to the ground. So this voltage is Vout, and we know that Vout is equal to Vm. So we have found that two different voltages. One is V saturation, one is VDSN. So like we have to check it for saturation region. We have this condition here. Like if we have to check for saturation. So we have our condition which basically says VDSN should be greater than or equal to like V saturation. So we need to check this condition here. Like we know that this VDSN this was equal to Vm, and this is equal to like VD minus Vm. So if we observe this expression here, this is equal to Vm is greater than equal to Vm minus like Vtn. So I think I have made a mistake here. This is our Vm minus Vtn. So here this quantity is like our positive quantity. Positive. So if this quantity is positive, it means that this condition is satisfied. If this condition is satisfied, we can say that this MOSFET NMOS is in NMOS is in saturation. And now we have to check for like this PMOS here. So for this PMOS, we draw this design again here. Like इसको हम दोबारा से draw कर लेते हैं, जो कि हमारे पास PMOS था. This is our ground terminal. This is our VDD. This is our ground terminal. We have V in here. We have out here. So now we have some different voltages. Like we have here. This is VSGP, and we have this is equal to VSD. So we have these two different voltages here. Like this is positive, this is negative, this is positive and this is negative, and this is VSDP. So we have these two different voltages. We have to observe what these voltages are, and this is obviously equal to Vm, and similarly Vout is equal to Vm. So हमें ये voltages observe करनी है और हमने ये देखना है कि how these voltages are related to Vm. So we have the saturation saturation current here, like which is equal to V sat is equal to VSGP minus VTP, that is like mod of VTP. like this voltage and obviously the threshold voltage here. So we have found like VSGP. This VSGP, if you observe it here, this VSGP is equal to like VDD minus Vin. Like if we subtract Vin from this VDD, you will get this VSGP. So this is represented by VDD minus Vin and minus VTP. So we have this the formula for the saturation here, and also we can say that VSDP, like this VSDP, this is equal to VDD minus V, this VDD minus V out, and you know that this V out is equal to VM, and so we can say that VSDP is equal to VDD minus VM. So we have to check the condition for V saturation here now. Condition for V saturation for PMOS is VSAT should be less than or equal to VSDNP. So if we put the values in these equations, we will get VDD minus VM and minus VTP, and this should be less than or equal to VSDP, which is given by VDD minus VM. So if you observe it here, these two terms cancel out each other, and we are left with zero here and a negative value here. So we can say that this term is basically lesser than this term. So this condition is satisfied. So if this condition is satisfied, it means that this PMOS is in saturation region. So now what we have to do is, if both our MOSFETs are in saturation region, we have to find this expression, or we have to solve this expression. IDN is equal to IDP, and for these equations for IDN and IDP, we have to use the current equations which we observed in our previous videos, ke unki jo values hain basically wo saturation region ke liye kya hoti hain. For IDN, we have beta n by 2 into VG, this is VGSN minus VTN whole square, and this is equal to beta p by 2, and when we have VSGP minus VTP whole square. So we have this equation for our for saturation regions for both MOSFETs. So here this value is VM, and we have this value as VDD minus VM. So we can put these values back in this equation, this upper equation. We will get we can simplify a little bit here, this two and this two will cancel out each other. So we are left with beta n divided by beta p, which is equal to VGSN minus VTN square, which is equal to, sorry, I have to replace this with VM, and we have on this side beta p. Sorry, I'm just making some mistakes here. So we have here VDD minus VM minus VTP, and this is for whole square here. So I have to solve this equation. We have to take square root on both sides, taking square root on both sides here. to slide a little bit. So taking root on both sides, we will get to like beta n by beta p, which is equal to like which will be equal to Vm minus Vtn. So this is not equal to what we are talking about this side as well. This is equal to Vdd minus Vm n minus Vtp. This is Vtp. Sorry, there is no square here. So this is Vtp. So what we do is we have to solve this expression for Vm. So we take this Vm. This Vm to this side of the equation, we will be left with like beta n by beta p and Vm. Similarly, we have this expression which is equal to beta n by beta p. If I take this on this side, this is Vm, this is equal to Vdd minus Vtp. If I rearrange this expression and solve it for like Vm, I will get it like somewhat like beta p Vm plus Vm, which is equal to, if I take this side on this other side, I think there is a mistake here. There should be an expression which is equal to Vtn. So if I take this expression on the other side, this will be equal to Vdd minus Vtp n plus beta n by beta p, and then we have Vtn. Obviously this Vtn is like outside of this square root. So if I solve this expression for Vm, taking Vm common and taking the rest of the expression on the other side of the equation, this final expression for Vm should be equal to Vdd minus Vtp beta n over beta p and Vtn all divided by 1 plus root of beta n divided by beta p. So this expression is for Vm. Like if you want to calculate this Vm here, you can calculate using this expression. So we can say that this Vm is controlled by like this we have this expression here, like ratios of controlled by ratios. Like what ratios? These are like beta n by beta p. So this beta n and beta p like controls the midpoint voltage. If we change this beta n and beta p, like this ratio, if we increase this ratio, this voltage will be changed, like Vm will update. So like this expression is for like to calculate this or like midpoint voltage. So we have seen it earlier, like beta n and beta p were equal to like k bar n divided by k bar p, with like, so this is given by w by l of n divided by w by l of p. So like these are the ratios which control the midpoint voltage, and they also contribute to this metric inverter designs. We have also seen earlier that this expression is equal to, like this ratio is equal to 2 or it can vary till 3. And we can also say that to design a symmetric inverter, it is necessary to have equal voltage, like equal voltage regions. We have seen this earlier. Like to design an inverter, to design a symmetric inverter, we should have equal voltage regions. What I mean by this statement is, like Vm should be equal to 1 by 2 VDD. It means that we must have like two different voltage regions where this region represents our low level and this region represents our high level. This condition should be satisfied to solve like this expression for the low level and high level design of our the symmetric design of our inverters.
So we have observed that for a symmetric inverter design, we have there are some points which we need to tackle for the calculations or for designing our symmetric inverters. The important point is like our midpoint voltage should be half of our like supply voltage. And the other important point which we observed is like midpoint voltage can be controlled by this factor like beta n by beta p. And or we can say that this eventually turns out to be W by L n and W by L n by p. So that we can control the sizing of our transistors. So इस तरह से आप अपना जो ट्रांजिस्टर है उसको आप डिजाइन कर सकते हैं जो इन्वर्टर है उसको आप डिजाइन कर सकते हैं. So this was an introduction to symmetric inverter designs. हम अपने next video session में इसकी detail में पढ़ेंगे कि उसको हम लोग कैसे डिजाइन कर सकते हैं और उसके लिए किस किस तरह की calculations जो हैं वो required हैं. So that's it for this video. I will see you in next video inshallah.